Thank you for coming in the summer, during the summer event. It's very hot, I know. That's why we talked to look at a speech to start the opening, and after we can just have a fun and talk to the artists as well, the exhibitors. So I'm very grateful that you came this evening. I would like to introduce the artists who are participating in this event. Vikas Jelvin from Hungary, he's a sculptor. Łukasz Patetyk from Poland arrived. That was for the second time. Just mentioned that in 2018 we already cooperated, and in the Polish Institute, in Plata Gallery, we made an exhibition for him. So it was 6 years ago, which was very, very fun, so it's nice that we can continue it. And of course, Patricia Ruk, who is also from Poland, she's curator of this exhibition, and we have a speech about the exhibition. So,
good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's a pleasure and honor to be here with you, and I want to say thank you to all artists who trusted me with this project. Thank you to Tomasz. Our collaboration started in 2015, and abstraction was always one of the central topics in our projects. So we continue this exploration. Maybe some of you have seen our previous project, Out of Bonds, which was our journey to biomorphic, abstraction, for organic, and we continued this research together, and probably you remember some of the works of Tomasz. You will see now a continuity of certain topics which we started. So today we speak about colliding dimensions, about multi-layered realities, and how these layers, they lead to certain tensions, they lead to collisions, giving us new context, new meaning, and totally new situations. So this is what we will be looking at today. I chose for us a quote for this project, and this quote comes from Wasily Kandinsky, who was working really actively with abstraction, and it says, "Painting is a thundering collision of different worlds, intended to create a new world in and from the struggle with one another, a new world which is the work of art." So here we are exploring through paintings and sculptures of Erwin, we are exploring these dynamics of colliding forms and cross-fading layers. And abstraction means like pulling away or drawing away from something. So this is a choice of distancing from any depiction. And here we can see that there is still certain representation, there are still certain objects which you can recognize. So there will be a lot of moments when you will say, yes, this looks sort of familiar. So this is kind of like departure from reality. So this can be slight, it can be partial or complete. So in colliding dimensions, we explore different stages of the separation through topics originating in scientific metaphors. Here, as an example, we can see that in Tomasz's works around in this room, and to referencing perspective of human nature integration. And this topic is explored in works of Łukasz and also in works of Erwin. You see the other room, sculptures which are really having this deep dive human nature relationship. So, as we already referenced Erwin's works, he works with materials he carves, twists, and cuts. There's a lot of very precise artisan work being done here, and I really encourage you to have a close look at these sculptures. We have four of these, the tower, we have two torsos and a misunderstood piece with the weapon. So he's working really close with abstract and figurative representation. And these two orders are cross-fading. He explores metaphors of the human world by his matching elements in unexpected combinations. A new layer of meaning is created. And he works a lot with geometric structures, where you can see like these objects, they lead to a perfect harmony. So again, I recommend you to go really closely to them and see how this work is depicting some real objects. He's multiplying, he's merging with abstract objects from nature. And I would want us to have a closer look at the misunderstood peace work, which is dedicated to the issue of weapon sacralization. And Erwin works with the topic of human animalia, where he's choosing the topics which bring us to paradoxes in human life. So this particular work, which you see in that room, it speaks about the weapon as a source of peace, which is kind of contradictory. But thinking about the global political context, we know that countries which have a very strong weapon, which could actually end up with total global disaster, these countries are perceived as places which are safe, because nobody would dare to attack them. So this sort of anomalies and paradoxes are inspiring Erwin's works. And that's just one of the topics, because Erwin also works actively with the landscape. He uses this landscape copy in the tower, for example. And you can see this is a mirrored image of the tower, part of the landscape of the city where we are. But this is blended with mushroom-like forms, which are inspired by nature. So there are these words cross-fading, and this is how Erwin brings us into new meanings. I really recommend you also to have a look at these two particular pieces. One is here the torso, and another torso. So we have two torsos. So this is kind of a play with the history of art and the context of the human representation. But here, actually, this is a piece of trash. This is a piece of trash which was enlarged. This is actually a packaging of pills. You can imagine that this is an enlarged packaging of pills. Mm-hmm. In the case of the other sculpture, in the other room, you can see this piece of the cheese wrapping. So if we think about nature, and we think about something which we would like to be to see sustainability in our life. We would like to be ecological. We would like to not create more pollution. We still will meet with this paradox that we, if we want to really purposefully protect food, if we want to protect medicine, we need to use these materials which are actually quite polluting, and they are really natural. So this is one of the anomalies which Erwin was also exploring in his works, with a very interesting effect of the manufacturing world, where this is a massive production. Here we see this is translated into wood, really natural material. And the way Erwin works is also very characteristic, because the way he sculpts is done in a way that none of the machines could replicate. So this is also this human aspect of being a creator and being able to create things which couldn't be created by other technology. So I also invite you to have a closer look, and of course speak with the artist, because he has a lot of stories to share with you about his works. So moving on to our painting representations from a glass series from Lukasz Patarczyk. Lukasz is developing the series over the last 3 years, and this is his experimentation and research on the edge of romantic landscape, as you can see, as the one of the layers, and contemporary abstraction. And we see, like, in this paintings, Lukasz started working with ovals, usually these are geometrical situations in different forms. You can see his works also the corridors, like large scale works. You can see this representation in all the rooms. So we can see there is the romantic landscape, again, very classic story, but there is a layer of geometric abstract meaning on that. So here we are exploring how this brings us a new context of two worlds meeting. Again, we have the natural aspect, so being close to nature and having this pure landscape. And on the other hand, we have something which is very geometrical, and Lukasz sees it as a human integration, as the world of perfect forms, which cannot be naturally observed in nature. This perfect geometry can exist only in a human world, human research, in a science. where we can see this perfect, precise forms in nature due to erosion, due to different processes happening around us. We cannot see this perfect symmetry, perfect geometry. So this is the combination of two orders, the nature and the human world, which is very technological, works with sharp forms. So here also we touched the similar topic of like how the human integration, how human actions are changing the landscape around us, or are changing our environment. We are seeing here this tension between like the natural, romanticized, and human interaction and the world humans building in separation from the origin, the natural. And I would like us to have a look now on Tomasz's works. Here from Tomasz we will see two series. The older series which you may recognize and remember, Crystals of Memory. And in this series, Tomasz is working with this laboratory-like objects, forms which sort of always look familiar. They look like under microscope, but at the same time, they don't really take this final shape which would help us understand what is actually happening there. And with Crystals of Memory, we can see that these forms, they are the carriers of certain messages. There is an information locked in them. They serve as sort of a chip for memory, or like a little memory unit. In his new series, the Luminous Decay, Tomasz is continuing this experiment, but you can see his forms are more oval. He started also working with tonals, and this is also a new format for him. And that really corresponds well with these new forms, which are softer, more luminous. But still, Tomasz is working with very dynamic compositions, and you can see that his interest in op art is becoming more and more important here. So he brings us to situations which are like really illusionary, and the closer we get to the painting, we start to understand there is much more and much more, and we really get immersed in this visual situation. So. I also invite you to have a closer look at how he works with his technique. And I'm sure like you will find here also a lot of visual joy in these situations. So with Luminous Decay, the research goes further. It's more about the situation where we are moving through different stages of the energy organization. So this is the moment of certain explosion. This is the moment where the situation which is sort of chaotic, but at the same time, this is the situation which brings the potential for new forms to be born out of the chaos. So here we can see like these are small galaxies-like forms, and they can be a beginning of a total new formation. They are now still in the state of vibration, strong energy dynamics, and we are in this moment when we can just imagine what's the next stage of this process. So I really invite you to speak with our artists, come closer to their work, observe how precise is this technique, how interesting and different are their ways of working. So please have a chat with our artists, you can ask your questions. And I want to say that you can also come to me and also ask me if you have any questions, and I wish you a beautiful exploration tonight, and I hope you also have nice chats and nice discussions about art, and this will be a pleasant evening for all of you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.